Hello, hello! What's up, everybody? My name is Mike Brown, aka Review King MB, and I am here to talk about, after coming back from a screening for Wish Upon. Wish Upon is a 2017 horror film that was directed by this guy, John Leonetti. And if that name sounds familiar, he's a guy that you may know for directing such classics like Mortal Kombat Annihilation, Annabelle, and The Butterfly Effect 2. So yes, it's easy to say that when I saw who was directing this movie, I didn't really have high hopes for it. But the plot is we meet Joey King, who plays Claire. She's this high school girl who has sort of a tragic background. Her mother killed herself, but she's trying to move past it. She's trying to go through high school. She gets bullied in school. It might sound a little typical, but she's having a hard time until she finds this box. And this box basically says it will grant her 7 wishes. Which sounds easy enough because they actually do come true. And it's pretty good for her at first. Then you come to find out that each and every wish comes with a price. And it will kill somebody close to her. Somebody around her will die for every wish that she makes. And so you come to a point where she has to figure out not only how to stop this, how to get rid of the box, but stop it before it ultimately tries to kill her. Now, what I thought of Wish Upon was, shockingly, I liked this movie. I did. Again, I was not expecting to think much about the film between the director and then even the trailer. I thought it had an interesting premise, an interesting concept, an interesting plot. It reminded me of, if anybody saw that movie, The Box, with Cameron Diaz and James Marsden, where it too had an interesting premise, but then when you watch the movie, it's very boring. It's very lame. It's just dull. There's not much going on here. So this movie almost took that interesting plot and did something with it, actually made the movie interesting, actually did stuff with the film, and that's what I enjoyed about it. You have Joey King, who, she's this actress that's been around for a little while, since she was young, one of the child actresses. I remember first seeing her, she must have been like 4 or 5 years old in that movie Quarantine. Little girl in that movie. She's gone on to do other horror films and just other movies here and there, and here she is. She was in The Conjuring. And I think she, if she stays on the right track, if she doesn't do drugs and alcohol and partying and do what every other child actor has done, then she will be okay. I think she has the acting chops. I liked how she pulled off some of these scenes with her character, dealing with her backstory and how that kind of screwed her up. And then even just something as simple as being a high school girl, being a girl who wants to be normal, doesn't want to be bullied anymore, wants this guy who looks like he's 25 years old, but she has a crush on him, she wants him to notice her, or she wants these things that might sound trivial, might sound frivolous, but she's the age that she is, so you go along with the character, and then even when she starts making these wishes and things start going her way, when the character finds out that people are dying because of it, you would think, well, she's a horrible person if she keeps making wishes or if she keeps doing this and that. But the film sets the rules up. The film clearly says that it starts to get a hold of you. It starts to almost control you. And like a drug, it makes you want to keep making wishes. It makes you want to do these things. So then she becomes a victim, sympathetic. And the screening I was in, the audience, the fans, they were eating some of these scenes up, laughing at moments that I wasn't quite sure if they were supposed to be funny, but they too made me laugh. I think the film is a crowd pleaser in that way. The death scenes, it reminded me a lot of Final Destination, just certain scenes where she makes a wish, so then that means we cut to a character that's close to her. And it's almost like you're sitting there going, okay, how are they going to die? Is it going to be that thing hanging up there or that thing over there? And then they end up dying a whole nother way. Like, they know how to build the tension of you waiting to see somebody die and getting into it in that way. The other characters, we have Ryan Phillippe as her father. Yes, Ryan Phillippe, an actor who I first remember seeing in movies like I Know You Did Last Summer and Cruel Intentions. It's a little random for him to be the father here, but he was good in the role. He got some things to do. The movie doesn't even shy away from the fact that he's still a good-looking guy. He is. They try to make him look all grungy and dirty with a little beard and he goes through the garbage with his friend. And he's a hoarder. He has all this trash around the house. He's supposed to look like some slob, but it's like, okay, come on. When he does clean himself up, you know he can get any woman that he wants. Shannon Purser, who people might remember as Barb from Stranger Things, she plays one of the best friends here. Sydney Park, who I remember seeing in The Walking Dead just last season. Her character, she could have been seen as a little annoying, but I thought she had funny moments as well. Again, high school kids. Ki Hong Lee. Here's something that I want to praise the movie for. How many times do you have it to where the guy who likes the girl, whether it's a horror movie or not, is just a typical white dude, a white kid, which is fine. Sometimes you might get lucky and get a black kid. Sometimes. Rare, but sometimes. The fact that they got this Asian kid, this Asian actor, who the only time I can ever remember thinking of seeing Asian characters in a movie like this is they're just very much the side character, maybe the comic relief, or maybe just someone to get killed off. But they actually made him a character. He showed interest in Joey King, and he was able to help further the plot and just be involved, be a real character. I appreciated that. I liked that. So ultimately, I'm going to give Wish Upon enthusiastic matinee. Definitely, if you guys get a chance, if you're interested, check out Wish Upon. It's surprisingly a pretty decent horror film. So guys, let me know in the comments below if you're interested in seeing Wish Upon, or if you've already seen it, what did you think of it? Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Later! Please won't you say desires, on fire. Sometimes you need a little peace at home. On fire, but so wired.